Hi, my name is Simon Howard and I'm a solution architect at Micro Focus. So this video is all about releases in FoD, Fortify in Demand, and how they relate to your physical application releases for your applications. And indeed, it's also about how applications in FoD and scans fit together with the releases, if you see what I mean. So let's look at that. So every application that you need to scan in FoD has to have an application definition. In fact, it has to have at least one application definition. And each application definition contains at least one release. That's where your results go into. The scan results go into releases. And on that point, each release will have a number of scans. So as you're developing, let's say 1.0, you're going to scan that many times, maybe nightly, within your CI pipeline. How do you create releases? Well, you can create releases manually in FoD in the web interface. It's really easy to do. And that would be created by someone within your team who has the privilege to do that, has a role that enables them to do that. That could be the team lead or perhaps could be any member of the team. And it becomes part of your process. And there's lots of use cases when you would create a release manually. When you name a release, well, the release names are strings. They're not numbers. So a release name could be 1.0, 2.0, and so on, or could be summer release. Release names, though, must be unique for the application definition in which they belong. In fact, application definition names or application names must also be unique as well for your tenant. But you can change release names and you can change application names retrospectively. The sort of best practices that for your naming is that you should name it in the way that best fits your naming convention. But there should be a clear mapping between the FoD release names and your actual release names. Now, if you want to, you can go ahead and create releases automatically using our REST APIs. We have lots of customers that do exactly that. A use case there might be that you're using Azure DevOps. You could create a PowerShell script to use our APIs, create the releases as part of the pipeline. So let's go and create a release. So to do that, in this application view here, we're going to go and look at the WG application, an existing application on this demo tenant. We're now in the releases view, and you can see there are six releases, 1 through to 6.0, that have been created. I'll create a new one manually. So to do that, I select new release, give it the release a name, so I'm going to follow on, I'm going to call it 7.0, and I need to give a description optionally, actually, of this release. I'm going to do that. This is the new release, let's say. It's optional, as I said. Then I need to define where it is in the SDLC. So in FoD, we have three SDL states, development, QA test, and production. So I'm going to say it's in development state. And I'm going to keep this checkbox checked. And this is quite a powerful checkbox. It enables me, when I create a new release, to inherit essentially the results and the triage effort that I've done. You know, so in other words, if I have suppressed vulnerabilities and I want to keep that in new release, I absolutely want to have this checked. So I'm going to keep that checked. Click Next. I'm going to say the release I want to inherit from, if you like, or copy the state information from. So 6.0. I'm not going to check this retire select release in my particular case, but I could do that. Click Save. And then my new release is being created. And here we go, here it is. Now, right now from this release details view, I could go ahead and scan this application by selecting Start Scan and Static. I'm not going to do that. Let's go back to the release view, sorry, the review we were on before, the releases view. And you can see there is version 7.0. Now, because I copied that state information, you can see the version 7 has exactly the same number of vulnerabilities, critical high, medium and low vulnerabilities, as version 6.0. So that's how I go and manually create the release. So how do releases fit on to your life cycle of your application, if you like, your release life cycle. So let's consider a few sort of scenarios. So what about an application that is released infrequently? You know, maybe once a month, let's say. So in that scenario, you may as well go and create the releases in FoD manually. You saw how easy it was to do. So a sort of kind of best practice would be just go ahead and create them manually. I mean, you could create them automatically using the REST APIs or a tool to use that, say in PowerShell. You might as well do it manually, if you like. What about an application where you are creating releases daily? We have customers that do exactly that. Then you don't really want to have to create those releases in FoD manually. It would break your CI pipeline. So logically, the way to do it is to have a script that's integrated into your pipeline, perhaps in PowerShell, as I said, which uses the REST APIs to go and create those releases. So that's really easy to do. That's a best practice. Create them using automated tooling. What about branches? Is there anything special about branches? Well, not really. So here we have a set of releases that we've created. We could quite easily create essentially a new release, which is actually for a branch that's been created by a developer. So we could do that, create that new release. We could do that manually, automatically, as we saw. And then that branch will appear to the developer, let's say within their IDE. When they're developing the code, they're happy, they've made the change, and they want to go and scan that. They, from within the supported IDE, like Visual Studio, for example, they could scan the code or initiate a scan from Visual Studio directly into that branch on the FoD tenant. So essentially, the best practice is if you're using branches, then you could use FoD releases for those branches. Okay, so this has been a set of sort of best practices, if you like, for the purpose of using releases. I hope you found the video useful. I'll see you in the next one.